If it isn't, who the hell y'all think it is?
Seem like my life been really changing on me. I know some niggas out here hating on me. Ayy, I see the bitches how they changing on me. I know some niggas out here snaking on me.
Ayy, seem like. Cause look, man, I already know everybody's like, Twiggy, where you been? I know I done been gone. Twiggy done been everywhere. We done been all across the world. Okay, I ain't gonna lie, we ain't go across the world. But I have been, you know what I'm saying, back and forth to Houston, going through a lot of things, which I already know. I got a lot of problems, you know, black people problems. Shh, black people problems, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of problems, but who don't got problems, you know what I'm saying? But your boy is back, like I posted today on YouTube. Your boy gonna sit there, we starting to post goddamn reactions, more reactions, podcasts, the studio. You see, I mean, you can't really see too much right now, but I got everything set up right now. Even more than what I had before, so like we in that thing. So shout out to the goddamn Twigger gang, you know. Yeah, it's a little bullshit shirt, it's fucked up, but you know, it's one of my little play shirts, you know what I'm saying? I just need to get back on this bitch and make some videos for y'all. Now, one thing, the comments shit, I've been going back and forth with a lot of people in the comments, man. I'm not finna get on that shit no more. If y'all got some bad negative to say, y'all can say, I'ma like it, I'ma love it, tell you thank you for your support, but I'm not finna go no further than that, because I'm not finna keep getting to it with everybody. This shit is dumb to me. It's old, but anyways, look, y'all ain't come here for me to talk, which I did miss me. I know you miss me. I miss me too. But anyways, look, bet the last video I did by Burden, that's what we finna do right now. Burden was We the People, if I'm not mistaken. And Burden hit me up. Shout out to Burden. I'll put that on a little screen. He did hit me up, DM me. Shout out, my nigga. What's up, Burden? But anyways, we had a little conversation about this and this and that, about the video, about my reaction, everything, dang. Boom, me and him, we good. We got good understanding. He sent me this video talking about Save Our Children. We had a conversation about, which in my last reaction, I talked about our children. How come we don't talk about our children? Then he watched the whole video and was like, you know what? My next video that's coming out is talk about Save Our Children. So bet, he sent it to me. So now we're here. So Burden, this one's for you, baby. This one's for you. Let's go ahead and record and push play. See what happened. Save Our Children. Our children do need to be saved though, man. Real talk, like we really do need to be thinking about our children, man, like for real. We all got kids, a lot of us got kids, we need to take care of them no matter what happens in our life, real talk.
Picture this, 4-year-old little girl, she don't play much, she don't smile, she don't laugh, she don't say much.
For real.
She don't know what it is to be a kid, she don't have any friends but grown men, and what they want,
yeah.
What they want, what they paid for, nobody think about the children till they take you.
That's some bullshit, like for real, man. I got all these little girls out here, man, who don't even know how to really live their life, you know what I'm saying? You got all these men who trying to throwing money and throwing, you know, jewelry and diamonds and cars and all this other shit just to get them out their panties, man. That's some bullshit. Like, little ass girls are really getting trafficked out here and everything else. Like, that's bullshit. Like, we really need to wake the fuck up, get away from politics, get away from all this other shit, racism shit, get away from all that and think about what's really at hand, because what's really at hand is our goddamn children. Our children are our future. You know what I'm saying? Like, real talk, our children is our future. Our children is going to make this goddamn country. Is this the type of country we finna keep leaving them? That it's okay for them to get trafficked. It's okay for them to get raped. It's okay for them to get sold. It's okay for them to get bought. It's okay for them just to, you know, throw them away like that. That's not cool, man. Man or woman. You know what I'm saying? That's not cool at all. But go ahead, Burden.
Doors. And nobody could imagine this could ever happen, to have a kid never living next door.
For real.
The truth could bring tears. 1.2 million children a year.
For real.
1.1 COVID deaths worldwide. You won't help save the kids, but you will live in fear. The
for real.
The more disgusted I get, that the world could commit so much horrible shit. So for the children, used, bruised and abused, to you I refuse to forget. I'll be looking for any other sign. If something isn't right, you can say it with your eyes. Tell me how a mother can...
For real, man. Like, for real. Like, you saw the missing goddamn papers behind them, that's y'all's child. That's somebody's child, you know what I'm saying? That's somebody's kid missing. Like, y'all report all these goddamn COVID deaths, man. He said 1 million, but at the time he made this video, which was on the 8th, it was probably out of 1 million. Now it's damn near 2 million. Just in, well, not in around the world, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's dumb. We over here talking about COVID this, COVID that, not the children, not nothing else, just COVID, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's bullshit. When we gonna get away from the bullshit and get away from what's really at hand? Like, real talk, what is it gonna take for us to really just take care of our goddamn children? Like, what is it really gonna take? It's not gonna take much, but just being there for your goddamn kids. That's all it is. Damn.
Sell the wrong baby and live with it for the rest of our life, man. It's crazy. You know,
about
the baby. We hear about the torture and all of the stories of horror, but we just ignore them. They don't wanna do it, but somebody forced them. What about the third trimester abortion?
Too real.
The fetus. Who sets the prices? Some kids will never know how precious life is. They're full of drugs and lay their life. They're shooting ready for the truth. But how hot this mic is, I gotta tell it. If you can ignore this, then you're heartless. I know we can take more out of the darkness.
Real.
Before they make your kid a target.
For real, man, what if it was your kid? Then what, you would care? You know what I'm saying? A lot of people ain't gonna care about a lot of situations because it's not their kids. It's not their shit. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people not really care about nothing. If it ain't got nothing to do with them or their family, they don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? If it's fucking with their pockets, they gonna care. If it's fucking with their future, they gonna care. But if it ain't fucking with them like that, they not really finna care about none of that shit. That's bullshit. Like, for real, man, our children is our children. Our children is what we used to be, and now we're living our life to become adults and be what we're doing now. So how come we, I mean, growing up when I grew up, the world was way a hell of a lot better. We ain't had none of this bullshit, you know what I'm saying? I grew up before we had cell phones. I was born in the 80s, you know what I'm saying? Before we had cell phones and shit like that, like it was done before we had internet, before we had none of that. That was good-ass life because you didn't have to worry about nobody. You didn't have to worry about nobody but the people on your block. You didn't have to worry about nobody in your city because you ain't fuck with them like that. Now you got to worry about all the world this, the world that, the world this, the world that. We need to be worried about these children. Fuck Trump, fuck Biden, fuck goddamn, like he said, you know what I'm saying? Y'all want to know about the beat and how the beat sound and shit like that, but y'all don't really care about what the children going through. They getting beat, getting sold, getting raped, getting chopped up, cut up, like, it's real life out here, but then nobody want to think about that. That's a reality, y'all. Y'all rather think about that other bullshit than think about what's really real and real. Like, come on, man. I hate this shit. Real talk. Should die before charges. Pedophiles should die before charges.
2020 statistics still show 1 out of 10 kids will be victims of human trafficking.
It's probably more than that.
200,000 of them kids are in the U.S. There's 130 people being trafficked every hour worldwide.
Every hour. Think about that shit.
30 million children have lost their childhoods to this horrendous activity.
30 million children. 30 million. That's a lot of goddamn children. 30 million children. How many people is in the United States? Like 100 something million? Something like that. I don't even think it's that many. You know what I'm saying? But damn, what, 20%? 30% of what? Goddamn, it's the children. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man. The statistics is high for this shit. But do we care about it? I'm not going to say we, but do I ain't even going to say y'all, because a lot of people going to watch this and like, feel some type of way. Like, yeah, I do care about it, actually, because they got children and shit like that. But I'm saying that the people and the pedophiles, like you said, pedophiles should get killed before they even get charged. How the fuck you sitting here getting, so like the little white dude to rape them little 30 kids or something, them little teenage kids, I mean, them little preschool kids or something like that? Or what was it? What was it? Daycare. Then he raped like 30-something kids or something in daycare. Nigga only got how many years, you know what I'm saying? Like, no, nigga, death. Nigga, I got my hair out, bitch, I'll kill you myself. Real talk. I ain't fucking with no pedophiles, man. Real talk. And I don't mean to try to say I'm gonna kill somebody and everything, but I will kill your bitch ass if you a pedophile. I don't give a fuck. I really don't care. Y'all can mark my words. I'm not trying to be no gangster, none of that shit, but just let the real niggas know, like, bro, if I had to, my nigga, I'd let you down. I don't give a fuck who you is. Real talk. Family members or not.
So I don't know about you, but for me, this is unacceptable.
For
the
real.
Change must happen.
It has to happen.
Look, there's kids being trafficked and trapped in the world that you don't think exist.
Ah, shit, what happened? This motherfucker stopped on me? Alright, so we only got one screen now. The other one done fucked up. I don't feel like trying to fuck with it.
Trusted and teach him and guide him through life. These people are sick. I look at these pictures of innocent children. Not all of them taken, but all of them missed.
For real.
I've been praying that somebody's coming to save them and make them feel happy and bliss. You do not need a kid. What superpowers to be a hero?
You don't.
Save our children. Let's spread awareness. See me, I'm willing to step up and speak on behalf of the millions.
You got to speak up. Thank you for speaking up.
Trafficking the rich and the poor of all races, selling kids.
Thank you for fucking speaking up, bro, because a lot of people not gonna speak up. A lot of people are scared to even say shit about anything because a lot of people don't want nobody coming at them, nobody this, nobody that. A lot of people won't even put their face on the goddamn camera or video or anything unless they got a filter, unless they got something. A lot of people scared of that shit. But look, I tried to search your video, bro. It wouldn't even pull up. You know, usually you type in the shit, it'll pull up right away. It wouldn't even pull up. I had to actually put burden, save our children, because they really is. He DM'd me and was like, bro, oh, was it him? No, I think he posted something. He was like, bro. No, he told me, he was like, man, they trying to sit here and they're, he said, share it everywhere, man. Like, do the reaction shit. He's like, man, they trying to sit here. No, it was on Instagram. Sorry. It was on Instagram. He was like, man, they trying to sit here and be it to where they're dumbing it down to where you can't find the video. Like, this bullshit. Because, I mean, YouTube, Google, everybody don't, they don't want y'all to know this shit because they get ran off the elites. The elites is paying these motherfuckers money to put this shit on there, to put that, take care, take this child, take that. Like, the elites is doing that shit, man. That's bullshit. Like, we really need to come up off our shit and wake the fuck up because our kids are next. What if it's your kid getting raped? You know what I'm saying? What if it's your child, your daughter, your son that got missing and took and shit? Then what you gonna do? We gotta care before this shit happens. That's why he doing this video, because he gives a fuck about our children. You know what I'm saying? Regardless if you fuck with Trump or fuck with Biden or whoever in politics, none of that shit matters. He fucks with the children. Our children's the one that matters the most. So when we let's step our game up and do something about the goddamn kids. Like, for real, man, this shit's stupid.
Like a store, and y'all's faces, I can't take it no more.
Real
the future depends on us. Right here in this
nation, does depend on
door.
Us.
They're hungry and cold, some sleep on the floor.
Real
they
talk.
Keep their head down, not allowed to look forward. Some never felt love, they only felt for.
And it's bullshit.
What if we could find them all and bring them home and heal them? Could we come together? Could we work together? Could we stay together now? Save our children.
Real talk. Real talk, we can all really come together and do shit that we really supposed to be doing, man. But a lot of people don't want to come together. Why? Because my skin's black and your skin's white. Your skin's Hispanic. Your skin's Asian. Your skin's Indian, Arabian, Iraqi. Now your skin's totally different than mine. So I can't fuck with you just because I don't like your color of your skin. Didn't they say black and white wasn't even color? So how the fuck do I get called black and white people get called white? It shouldn't even be like that. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. Like, the way the world goes, man, it's like, it's total fucking chaos, total stupid. The world is just dumb now. It's dumb. Everybody, well, if you don't like the United States, do whatever. It doesn't matter what country you're in, this shit happens. Like, it happens. Every country, every state, every city probably got a missing person, bro. Like, seriously. We really need to come the fuck together, man. Save our children. Shout out to goddamn Burden for doing this damn song. Real talk. Shout out to Burden for doing this shit, because he ain't have to do this shit. But he gives a fuck. A lot of people not gonna care. I didn't mean to start it over, but a lot of people not gonna care about the shit that they doing, because shit, it ain't gonna benefit them. If it ain't benefiting them, why should they give a fuck? You know what I'm saying? Why should they care if it's not benefiting them? That's how people are nowadays, and I hate that shit, man. We really do need to save our children. They're going to say, well, John, well, Twigger, what you going to do about the kids? Look, I take care of my kids. And I'm actually, once I get this platform a lot better than a lot of other platforms, I'm not going to say once because I'm already trying to help these kids now. But once I, you know, get my shit up more, I can do a lot more. You know what I'm saying? I want to start a goddamn, a foundation in my daughter's name, that passed, Brooklyn Foundation, you know what I'm saying, to help premature kids, help kids, period. Any kid needs help with anything. I'm trying to start something like that. Now, that's my word. I got to give my word, and I got to back it up. It's going to take me a little time to do it, but I'm still do it. At least I'm on air trying to tell people, like, hey, I really want to do something about these kids, you know what I'm saying, because it's not fair. It's not fair, and nobody ever cares unless it's your child. Let's care before it's your child, because regardless if it's your child or not, it's a child. Damn, it's a child. These kids need saving. These kids need to have something. It's sad that these kids don't even get to get what they really need in the world because what? Everything. I don't even pinpoint nothing because it's everything. Everything in this stupid-ass fucking box. Everybody wants to put everything in the box. Nobody wants to look outside that box and think about what real reality is. Nobody wants to do that shit. Why not? Because you worry about money. You worry about your race. You worry about this, and that. None of that matters right now. It really doesn't matter, because once your child gets took, your job, everything is finna go down because your mind's finna be gone. You're gonna be all fucked up. So none of that shit really matters. You know what I'm saying? All these people, all these goddamn parents is putting that, the parents who's letting their little girls wear these short ass shorts. I'm talking about little girls, from three. You know what I'm saying? From three up. Niggas, men, look at that shit. You know, it's nasty ass fucking men. Doesn't matter what. Like, y'all let a little girl wear shorts, like short ass shorts. Damn near ass cheeks hanging out. Little low cut shirts. You get dressing y'all. I'm talking about the women. You dressing y'all's women, y'all's daughters as goddamn, making them look older than what they fucking supposed to be looking. No, I feel like little girls should have no makeup, no nothing. Nigga, say at least 16. You know what I'm saying? At least 16. No earrings. No nothing. At least 16. Even at 16, you don't need that shit. 18, you know what I'm saying? Then you can do what the fuck you want to do. Because a man ain't going to give a fuck. A dirty ass, nasty ass fuck man ain't going to give a fuck about what your age is. If he want it, he going to take that shit. I wish a nigga would take something from my daughter, bitch ass nigga. I'll kill you. Shout out.